Friday evening, March 15th, 1822. After the two delightful evenings spent yesterday and the day before, I shall certainly not go out tonight, but will sit here at home and write to you. Besides, my Adele, my adorable and adored Adele, what have I not to tell you? For 2 days I have been asking myself every moment if such happiness is not a dream. It seems to me that what I feel is not of earth. I cannot yet comprehend this cloudless heaven. You do not yet know, Adele, to what I had resigned myself. Alas, do I know it myself? Because I was weak, I fancied I was calm. Because I was preparing myself for all the mad follies of despair, I thought I was courageous and resigned. Ah, let me cast myself humbly at your feet, you who are so grand, so tender, and so strong. I had been thinking that the utmost limit of my devotion could only be the sacrifice of my life, but you, my generous love, were ready to sacrifice for me the repose of yours. My Adele, why is there no word for this but joy? Is it because there is no power in human speech to express such happiness? The sudden bound from mournful resignation to infinite felicity seemed to upset me. Even now I am still beside myself, and sometimes I tremble lest I should suddenly awaken from this dream divine. Oh, now you are mine. At last you are mine. Soon, in a few months, perhaps my angel will sleep in my arms, will awaken in my arms, will live there. All your thoughts at all moments, all your looks will be for me. All my thoughts, all my moments, all my looks will be for you, my Adele. And now you will belong to me. Now I am called on earth to enjoy celestial felicity. I see you as my young wife, then a young mother, but always the same, always my Adele, as tender, as adored in the chastity of married life, as in the virgin days of your first love. Dear love, answer me. Tell me if you can conceive the happiness of love immortal in an eternal union, and that will be ours someday. My Adele, no obstacle will now discourage me, either in my writing or in my attempt to gain a pension. For every step I take to attain success in both will bring me nearer to you. How could anything now seem painful to me? Do not think so ill of me as to believe that, I implore you. What is a little toil if it conquers so much happiness? Have I not 1,000 times implored heaven to let me purchase it at the price of my blood? Oh, how happy I am, how happy I am going to be. Adieu, my angel, my beloved Adele, adieu. I will kiss your hair and go to bed. Still, I am far from you, but I can dream of you. Soon, perhaps, you will be at my side. Adieu. Pardon the delirium of your husband who embraces you and who adores you, both for this life and another. Victor.